The European context, of course, is, you know, it is a hive of activity at the moment. And in some respects, it's almost like, you know, particularly when you look at the impact of institutional review, you know, anecdotally, institutions are coming back and saying, you know, we have been reviewed to death, but you need to make sure that this is placed appropriately. But this is reflecting activity which is occurring around the place. For instance, back in 2005, as part of the Bologna process, ENQA, which is the European Quality Assurance Agency, had agreed or set a common framework. And basically, they had established a series of standards, if you wish to use that term, for internal quality assurance within the institutions themselves. They also looked at higher education itself, the external dimension to it, and also the agencies that were involved in external quality assurance. And very much now what you'll hear, what you'll see, the acronym ESG, you'll see that fed throughout various documents, like assessment and standards, like institutional review. And they're informing where we're going. You know, and I think it's quite important, and it's something that I allude to when we talk about the culture. Very important to get this in context. Standards are constantly moving, you know, and we need to make sure that our systems and our processes are going along that, but in an appropriate way. In terms of its recent recent submission to the Bologna ministerial meeting, as we, you may be aware, there's a 10th anniversary meeting of the Bologna process in March 2010. And again, key messages in terms of its documentation that it placed before the ministerial meeting. It referred to primary responsibility for quality assurance lies within the institution itself. And I think that's a very important thing. This is not HETAC. This is actually about institutions doing this on a day-to-day basis and having ownership of quality assurance. It also emphasised the notion that very often perhaps we lose sight of, but the internal quality assurance dimension is critically, and it's due to, it's part of the duty of higher education institutions. And it made, you know, this is perhaps a standard point in a European context, the notion about the institutional review. And, you know, Garrod alluded to, our institutions enjoy substantial autonomy in terms of their activity, in terms of how they manage their business. But that ain't so, particularly when you see across in the European context. But they were just emphasising the notion that effective quality assurance culture ties in very much to which the degree and the level of autonomy that exists within the institution itself.